So I'm out getting me some breakfast this morning, and I hear this awesome choir. I'm gonna let y'all listen to them. Try to let y'all see them. My God is awesome. I love it because my God is awesome. Our God is. Hey, Dons and Divas, this is Saturday. I had to wake up at 3 in the morning, and I didn't go to sleep last night till 3 in the morning. So I've basically been up for 24 hours, but I got some pretty good sleep, maybe about 7 hours today. And so I decided to get up and take a walk around, and I found the park. It was absolutely just, you know, New York, you know, and so everybody's in there. And so when I first walk up, a squirrel walks up to me, and I'm like, oh my God, he like up with his paws up, almost scared me. And I realized that people be feeding the animals, and so I was like, okay. So I found the bench, sat on it, and all the birds came around me. I was like, okay. And I got in the water, and that was nice. And so now I'm walking back, and of course, I got lost. So I don't know. I think I just walked too far up. I don't even know. I feel like right now, yeah, I walked too far up because I'm coming back. And so I had to put it in the GPS. And so now I am walking back to the hotel, and It's hot out here, but it's nice. I am enjoying myself immensely. Andre had his class today, so it's still going on right now. The parties last night were amazing. As you see, it was an after party, but I was just kind of exhausted, so I did not tape the after party, but it was so nice. It was at a dance studio. And they had chairs in the front where you can just sit out and chill. And then they had a little area in the back that was just with the lights. It was just so cozy. I was like, this is straight New York. And I loved every minute of it. So I don't know if it's a day party today. If not, we'll definitely see. You guys will see the main event. So time to go get some rest. So I'm walking past, and I guess I'm on the side of the Apollo. And I've never been on this side before, so this is pretty cool. You know, I just seen the front of it, and I guess it's, these are entries, or I don't know, exits. Don't see any door handles. But this is pretty cool. Okay. My lost walk. Okay, Dons and Divas. This is New York's main event. Here I am, ready to get on the elevator now. Oh, okay. Is it going down?
I'm going down.
Oh.
I'm sorry.
Yes, okay. Okay, you guys, we are on our way to the main event. Yes.
Prelims.
Oh, it is New York prelims.
Yes,
I keep forgetting. Ooh, oh, you turned the light out.
That's all right. That's all right.
That's okay. That's okay. So we're on our way up.
Hey.
Hey. right here. To the 12th floor, you guys.
Yes, rooftop.
Oh, it's rooftop. I love it.
Well, then we got
to say rooftop. Hey.
I learned your move and use it all the time.
That's pretty, yeah.
But that's what's up.
Yeah.
That's beautiful. Hey!
gotta stay on the car.
Let's give it up for yourselves. Come on, y'all. Give yourselves a round of applause. Let's give it up for my man, DJ Shorty Smooth, been on the walls until y'all weekend. And at this moment, let me bring the individuals that's responsible for this weekend to the floor. Let me get my man Marty to the floor. Vet to the floor. Marty, Vet, I need you guys up here. Marty, Vet, need you on the floor, sweetheart. Let's give it up for these individuals that's responsible for this event. It takes a lot of time, hard effort, money to put these events together but without you guys, would anything be possible? I'm gonna turn it over to Marty for a second and then we're gonna get the contest started.
Thank you, Pete. I'm gonna call some more people up here. Devin Winfield. Devin. Who's Devin Winfield?
Devin!
Brian
Hosty.
Brian.
Woo!
Come on, I did. So yeah, just want to introduce you guys to the team, the organizers of this particular event. The people here also are the lead instructors in New York City, the New York Steppers. So somebody back there, knock on the door and see if Devin's in front. Okay, she'll be back. She'll be up. Yes, just want to thank y'all real quickly for coming out. I don't know if this is the part of the program where we're going to do this, but thank you guys so much. I hope you guys have enjoyed yourselves so far this weekend. I hope you guys enjoying this venue right now. Want to thank Pete Fraser for being here. Thank you, Pete. Y'all don't know Pete. President of Majestic Jazz has been doing the world's largest stepping competition for, I don't know how long, a couple decades? Yeah. Couple of decades, okay? So it's a real honor and a pleasure for him to be here to do this prelim for the World's Largest Steppers Contest 2023. One of the reasons why I've been on Pete, we've done this before, a few years ago we had a prelim, but I wanted Pete to come out here to the East Coast and make sure that he spent some time up here checking out what the East Coast is all about, especially in the Northeast. Here's Devin. Devin Davis. Give Devin a hand, y'all. Yeah, so we're gonna get this prenup started. I want to introduce you guys to some more people. I guess we can do that afterwards because I know you're ready to check out the competition. Pete, thanks for being here, man. We're gonna get this started. Thank you, DJ Shorty Smooth. We are indebted to you for being here. Thank you. So thank y'all. For now, Yvette. You should say something. Yvette's been working real hard this weekend. I'm gonna turn it over to her so she can say it.
This is a team effort. We have a wonderful team that has put this thing together. We had a vision, Marty had a vision, and we worked this vision through. We like to know and want to make sure that you all are all okay, that you are enjoying yourself and you're getting your step on. We want you to enjoy yourself to the fullest. Come back to New York.
We love New York!
To be represented in this world largest contest and let everybody know we're stepping over here.
Okay, since we're acknowledging people, I really want to bring up Michael Hamilton. Mike, come on up here.
Come on, Mike.
Because I don't want the night to go on without thanking Mike. Mike has done so much for this organization, so much this weekend. We've been killing him. He's been driving around, hauling things, and just he's been a central part of the New York Steppers. So I don't know if Mike is around. Is Mike around? Or we're just gonna get started.
Let's get started.
Okay, he's at the door. We'll introduce Mike after this.
The floor is bigger than this whole place, so get your tickets at shotstopper.com, September 15th, World Artist Pre-Party. Thank y'all.
William Harris and Julie Carey. Let's give it up for them, y'all. Let's give it up. William Harris and Julie Carey, number 5.
What category?
Let's do this.
What's that category?
Let's do this.
I'm not asking if you put up a bill.
What
category you guys want? Old school?
Yeah, to get the old folks out here.
Yeah, yeah.
This is
coming up 5. Old school, 6 feet over. Let's show us some love, as if you're ready. You got to represent the old school now. You want to bring it? You can show the school. Let's go to work. Just show some love, y'all, as they get started.
Thank you.
man named Rose and Amanda Russell. Named Rose and Amanda Russell.
Big City Weekend, Rosina Love, Big City Weekend. We wanted to take some time just to think about her for a moment. And I'm actually gonna bring up one of her tightest friends and buddies who started out stepping with her. She's gonna say a few words and introduce some special people that are here with us on behalf of us about Rosina.
Volunteers for the New York Steppers, and she would collect at the door, teach people to dance, hand out flyers, and help whenever needed. She loved stepping and missed it when she couldn't. She was amazing and inspirational. She inspired us all. In 2017, when she had to have surgery to remove a tumor one day before our Alaskan cruise. And she continued to inspire us all with her determination to fight with style and dignity. No matter what she was going through, she continued to share her generosity, caring heart, giving money to the less fortunate, and continued to live life and travel and supported me through my illness all within the last 2 years. One story I want to share is that one Saturday, we had a stepping event to go to, and she was gonna miss it because she had her annual family celebration early in the day that she invited me to. She told me that it was too much and she would not make it at the beginning of the week. But by 6 p.m. that day, she had changed her mind because she said it was too late for me to go by myself and she would be ready by 9. And everybody knows she was in bed by 8 o'clock. Other times, when she couldn't make it, she would tell me, make sure Michael and Marty walk me to my car. I would tell her, I'm from the Bronx, I'm good. She would say, Melina, do you hear me? Yes, I hear you. The next day she would ask, who walked me to my car? I would say, oh, I can't remember. So now that you're watching over me, just give me a 10-minute head start. You better make it 20. As the Golden Girl said, thank you for being a friend, driving the road and back again.
Yes.
Your heart was true, and you were a pal and a confidant. Thank you for being our friend.
I feel